Hey y'all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys my New Year's 2023 resolutions. I'm gonna be showing you guys how to make effective and realistic goals and give you some ideas and just how to be a boss for the year.
Subscribe.
So first thing, y'all, that you really wanna figure out is like, what is your theme? What is the main kind of focus that you wanna have for the new year? So for the new year, I want to be at peace, I want to be happy, and I want to heal. So those are the three things that I really want to focus on, which I feel like they all go hand in hand and they all impact each other, which is why I feel like they are all achievable in 2023. So now that you have this figured out, you really want to start reflecting. Reflect on the year before. So it's 2022. You want to reflect on the year of 2022 and think about what got in the way of you achieving the theme that you have for 2023. So for me, I'm thinking about what caused me to not be calm, to not be happy, what disrupted my healing process. A lot of people run away from this part because it's hard to reflect and it's hard to be honest with yourself. Life is reflection. There's no way that you can grow and there's no way that you can progress in life without reflection, because you have to think about things like, oh, okay, this didn't work, so let me try something else. Oh, this worked, so let me do this. Oh, this got in the way of this goal, so I need to stop doing this. And that's the hardest part, honestly, for me. So for me, I had to do a lot of reflection. One major thing is I let other people disrupt my energy and how calm I am and my peace. And you're in control of your own peace. So there should be no reason why other people should impact your energy or your space. You should never allow people to impact your space in a negative way. If people are not treating me a certain way, I have to have enough strength to be like, okay, no, I'm not gonna allow you in my space because you do not deserve my energy. I always put everyone else before myself, and it has to be a healthy balance. You don't live in the world alone. There are others around you. Life is about others, giving to others, and giving to yourself. So you have to find a healthy balance. And I was just giving and giving and giving to others and not putting enough into myself. Another thing is, I think that's like something that all of us probably have problems with. I was very, very hard on myself, and I didn't allow myself to be human and make mistakes. Mistakes are a part of life. You want to make mistakes because that's the way that you can learn the lessons that you need to learn and you can grow. But I always felt the need to be a perfectionist, and that disrupted my peace because I was always upset when I felt like I was failing, but I wasn't. I was learning. There's also a bunch of things that I want for myself that I'm not achieving because I'm not putting enough energy into it. Like, I want to start eating a lot healthier, and I want to start working out on a consistent basis. And because I didn't feel like I was doing that, I wasn't eating enough. Like, my health wasn't where I wanted it to be. My mental state was not in a peaceful place. I was just depressed all the time and unhappy because I was unhappy with my life. That's my reflection. Now you have to figure out yours. What are the things that were getting in the way of you achieving these goals that you have for 2023 in your theme? Once you reflect on what was impacting that, now you can be like, okay, what can I do to be better? I want to stop allowing external things or people to impact my mental state. When I feel like somebody is interrupting my peace, I'm gonna do some self-care, focus on myself. Maybe when I realize that I'm putting too much into others, I put into myself, I do some self-care. I get to know myself more instead of always putting into other people. Another thing I had was to come up with a workout plan and a health plan so that I can get myself together. I know that I'm somebody that kind of needs a plan, so that's what I want to do for the new year. Just kind of come up with a workout plan and a health plan. However, I feel like what we tend to do is we have these big goals and we tend to do unrealistic goals. Like, I know I'm not going to go from not working out much to working out every day. That's an unrealistic goal. Now, can I work out 3 days a week? Yeah, I can work out 3 days a week. So let me make my goal. Okay, I'm going to work out 3 days a week. I just know how I work. So creating realistic goals for myself so that I'm not easily disappointed and being realistic about my goals is also important in goal making. Another goal that I have is to react less. Y'all know, whoever knows me, when I react, I react and I say things I don't mean. I get upset because I'm not calming myself before I have certain conversations, or I just build so much up that I start literally like lashing out. And so that's something I want to work on. I want to work on reacting less. I also feel like reacting so much is not always the right option. Sometimes it's better to not react. It's better to not give something your attention, especially when it is with somebody that does not deserve your time or energy. And so I want to work on that more. So I want to meditate, and I really, really want to get into meditation this year, like big time. But I also want to get into journaling more and doing my like self-work journals and my word searches and things like that, because those are things that calm me and will allow me to reflect on a daily basis. So I really want to get into that. I would literally have like a goal board in like your room or something, and every time you reach a goal, check it off. Like, it feels so good to check off that box. Even if you don't reach a goal, like, applaud yourself for trying, because you know what? At least you made the effort. I think the key to being successful in the new year is putting in the work. You don't just have like a successful life and achieve success without like putting in the work. You have to put in the work to achieve what you want. And so work for it. It's not always gonna be easy, and it's not always gonna be handed to you. You're gonna have moments where you feel like you failed. Stay motivated and correct yourself. When you see yourself falling off, be like, okay, no, I'm gonna get back on track. I'm gonna be disciplined. It takes discipline. It takes work. It takes all of that.
Y'all, so I tried, and I was trying to get a video of it up, and then it fell down. I did try, but it didn't work out, and then like it's just gonna look messy. So yeah.
Obviously building the hot cocoa stand failed, but that's a prime example of how things happen. You just gotta keep going. So I hope you guys have a good, great new year. I wish you guys the best, and see you guys in my next video.